only interested in the cover. Now, Sarah, go ahead. Continue. What happened next?
Well, I showed Albert the cover, and I could tell he thought it was really neat, too. And I told him my brother Daniel and little Charlie Wilson. That's his friend. I told him how they sent away for the End of the World special. That's some really terrific fireworks. But I knew they weren't going to get it because it was against the law and everything. And I told Albert that's why I was selling the post, to get some money and go to Easton, where you can still get them, and buy some fireworks so Daniel and Charlie wouldn't be too disappointed. Of course, I was planning to shoot some, too. Well, Albert subscribed for a year to the post, and that's when I found out his name.
And, thank you. And what happened then?
He got on his bicycle and went home.
Well, did you see Albert again?
Uh-huh. It was about a week later. It was on a Saturday, on State Street. I was selling magazines, only no one was buying. And Albert saw me.
Did he talk to you?
Well, he carries a notepad, you know, in his pocket. And he prints everything.
But what did he say?
He told me he was making a surprise for Daniel and Charlie and everybody.
And, what kind of surprise?
Fireworks. He was making fireworks. That's why I had that gunpowder and everything. He knows how to make rockets that explode in four colors, and even in designs. He learned all about it in the Army.
Sarah, why would Albert want to make fireworks?
Well, he never said, not in so many words. But most of the kids laugh at him all the time and make jokes because he's different. And he doesn't have any friends. That is not counting me. And so I think he was making the fireworks because he knew it would make us happy. Then maybe everyone would like him. And he wouldn't be lonely anymore.
If it please the court, the state will call Sarah Cooper to the stand.
Ed, no.
And always a jerk for wanting to tangle with Sarah.
Yeah, I wouldn't mess with her.
Sarah, my dear, you understand that you are still under oath?
Yes, sir.
You may sit down.
The difference between love and like?
Sure.
Could you give us an example?
Well, I like peppermint, but I love chocolate.
Could you give us a people example?
I love lots of people.
Your Honor, the defense objects to this line of questioning as ambiguous and calling for speculation.
Yes, I think the distinction made between peppermint and chocolate is excellent.
Wish I'd thought of it myself.
Your Honor, I appreciate the special qualities of this witness, but 9 or 90, she's a character witness for the accused. I'm trying to pursue this as tactfully as possible, but the state is entitled to determine if the witness is biased or prejudiced.
Very well. Objection overruled.
But please get to the point.
Sarah, not counting yesterday in this courtroom, have you ever seen these explosives before? Do you want me to repeat the question?
Yes.
All right. Not counting yesterday.
No. I mean, yes.
You mean, yes, you've seen them before. Where did you see them?
Albert showed them to me.
Where were you when he showed them to you?
I was... They were in Albert's room.
In his room? You were in his hotel room?
He wanted to show me. He wanted me to see the stuff for the fireworks.
In his room? He took you to his room?
Your Honor, that question has been asked and answered.
Thus, Dan, proceed.
How often have you been to his room, Sarah?
Your Honor, that question is insinuating and inflammatory. The prosecutor is trying to mislead the jury, Your Honor.
Your Honor, I am trying to establish the nature of their relationship.
Relationship? What do you mean, relationship?
Counselor, you will take your seat or be held in contempt. And you, sir, are advised that you're treading on very thin ice.
Your Honor, I am aware that this is a delicate area. However, it is essential that we be allowed to establish that this witness' previous testimony was indeed biased and prejudicial, that she was, in fact, deliberately trying to protect the accused.
Very well, if that is your intent, but please get to it.
Now, Sarah, how many times were you in Albert's room?
Once. Just that once. To see.
What else did you do in his room, Sarah?
Your Honor, you can't allow this!
What else did you do in his room?
Your Honor, in the
what
name
else?
Of God and of decency, you must stop this!
The prosecutor will stop harassing this!
What did he do to you, Sarah? What did he do?
Order in the court. Order.